John from Boating New Zealand magazine. Today we're aboard the Prestige 420S, fine new boat, their first one in the Southern Hemisphere. Let's take a look on board. So the cockpit's a nice social area. We've got this really comfortable, expansive sort of seating area here, a nice teak table. It drops down as well if you wish it to, but it's there's a lot of storage under there, which is also accessible from the swim platform. That's quite a useful feature. At the moment, I believe the tender is kept in there. One of the things that Ōraki Marine does very well is that they equip all of their boats with things for the New Zealand market, and that includes the bait station on the swim platform, a particularly wide swim platform actually, which is a handy feature. The owner of this boat really likes to fish, so he set this boat up for a bit of fishing, and that bait station etc. gets quite a bit of use. Another Ōraki Marine innovation, if you like, a little add-on, is this rod rack. It's a good use of the space here underneath the hard top ceiling. Something else of note is this electric awning. It virtually turns this cockpit into another room. It comes all the way across. A really nice feature. It's something that the owners particularly enjoy. So moving inside, we've got the galley aft, and this is a feature that the owners also like a lot. Their previous launch had the galley down, and Avery felt that she was often sort of trapped down below when everybody else was up here socializing. So this one opens up nicely onto the cockpit. It's also in great communication with the saloon itself. The vessel features the stacking sliding doors, so the cockpit opens right out to the rest of the boat. That works very well. They've gone for this dark wingay trim. It is an optional extra on this boat. Normally they come with a lighter trim, but I think it works very well. It's a nice contrast with the whites and the creams and things that they've used here in the interior. Where I'm standing, this is the second access to the engine room, so you've got access from the cockpit or here from underneath the sole of the galley here. We've got a couple of Cummins engines in there. They're V drives, which means that they're nice and compact inside the engine room space. It's quite roomy down there, so much so that the owners have actually put a Waco freezer down there as well, which has freed up more space in the galley here. It's notable actually in this boat in general just how much storage space there is. They really have thought about using all of the different little cubby holes and spaces, and they're useful spaces as well. They're things that you can think, gee, I can use that, I can put something in there. And of course the owners have done that. They've had this boat since December, so they've had the time to figure out where things go. So you have to remind yourself that this is only a 42-foot boat. This saloon does feel quite spacious, and partly that's because it does open all the way out to the cockpit. Although, you know, you're up a step here, you're up a level, which means you've got really good sight lines out through the windows. This settee that I'm sitting on, it's a sort of a C-shaped settee, quite handy. It's got storage underneath it. The table drops down, which is useful if you need another berth. That then converts this whole seating area to another good size double, with the addition of the cushion from the bench seat on the other side. Look, this is a very ergonomic helm for me. It fits me really quite well. I'm not a super tall man by any means, but for me everything falls into place here quite nicely. It's well laid out. You can see the screens here. It's good vision ahead, good vision to the side. The little side window gives you a bit of ventilation, but it's also a place to poke your head out when you're perhaps berthing the boat or something like that. In terms of performance, this boat does get along very nicely. You've got 30 knot plus top speed, but you know, for most of your general boating needs, you'll be cruising between 18 and maybe 23 knots, and at that speed she's both economical and very comfortable. So these are all digital controls, really really smooth. There's no clunking in and out of gear. They work very well. This is fitted with a Cummins joystick control system, so even though it's shaft drive, the V drives as I mentioned before, it gives you excellent control. It also integrates the bow thruster. The whole system works very well, certainly no issues getting this in and out of a berth. The boat comes from the factory with a single Raymarine multifunction display. The owner wanted two displays, so he ordered the other one in New Zealand, and that was fitted here by Ōraki Marine to get the sort of layout we see today. They also took care of the anchoring system. We've got a quick capstan on the bow, a Rockner anchor. They've up-specced the anchor chain and so on, just to make it suitable for New Zealand boating conditions. Another feature of this vessel is the electric sunroof. It's really, really big. It opens up the whole space, lets in the light, lets the heat out of the saloon as well, which can be very nice, but great to be able to let the sunshine in, let the air circulate through the saloon and into the boat. This is a two cabin layout. That said, this cabin in the bow is a really good size. In fact, it's got a king size island bed, which again is unusual in a vessel of this size. It's also got a semi ensuite bathroom off the cabin, which is a nice touch. That's also the day head, obviously, that can be accessed through this door here, but also from inside the cabin. Now, that bathroom features its own shower box, again a nice touch in a boat of this size. And in fact, the whole cabin feels quite spacious. The whole forward cabin feels quite spacious. We've got a skylight overhead, nice natural light coming in through the side windows, and plenty of built-in storage, not only in hanging lockers either side, but also along either side of the bed. So perhaps the very best feature of this particular model is this full beam master cabin. This is something new for the 420. The 420 is a model that has been around for a while, but this particular boat, this particular new line from Prestige has been revamped, and this is one of the changes they've made. So this cabin has kind of been turned around. We've now got a king size island bed running fore and aft instead of athwartships. Love the nice big side windows. We've got ports on them as well, so you get a bit of air circulating through here. There's a pop-up TV on the side. Look, this is a really, really nice, spacious cabin for a boat of this size, and I don't think there'll be too many other 42-foot boats that offer this kind of a accommodation down here. So, this being the master cabin, has its own ensuite bathroom, separate shower box as well. So finish our walkthrough of the 420S up on the bow. Again, we've got these nice big lounging area here. This whole deck, in fact, is devoted to enjoying the sunshine. I like the way the backrests work, nice and simple. They're actually quite comfortable, and you know, if you've got kids on board or people who enjoy a little bit of sunbathing or swimming, this is a great spot to sort of base your water fun from. So that's Prestige's 420S. It's a model that I think will be quite popular here because it's a size that does seem to suit the New Zealand boating lifestyle quite well. It definitely offers a whole lot of space for its length, and I think people will like the styling. It has that sort of European flair. There's a certain simplicity to the interior, but it's also stylish, and that's a nice combination. In terms of performance, it goes very well. It is also available with Volvo power, but this particular owner was determined to have shaft power, and he's gone with the Cummins, and again it works very, very well as a combination. John Akelsain from Boating New Zealand. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more of these videos, please subscribe to our channel.